I'm interested in this. This is interesting.
So, what to do? You hold it like this. Just hold it still. Squeeze or like not much harder than that. Just very light.
Do you know that your colleagues?
What do you mean?
He is a colleague of yours.
I don't know.
He is, really, really.
So, the purpose of this is to find out what causes your stress. So, this is what we're going to try to find out.
Yeah.
And this is how it works.
Yeah.
I'll ask you something, and then when you think of something that causes your stress, this meeting, what can you do?
All right.
That's how it works. I'll just start with that.
Very stressed.
Do you think you look stressed?
No, you don't have to be stressed right now to have a reaction. Think of different people and situations in your life.
Yeah.
So I just move this a little bit so you can see the reaction. So yeah. There you have, what were you thinking about now?
Different people?
Yeah, some specific. You don't need to name it if you don't want it, but you were thinking of some specific person or situation?
Yeah.
Good. So there seems to be some stress there. It's related to that person is doing too.
Can I ask you who it was?
No.
I'm pretty sure I know who it is.
It's also a personal thing if you want to tell it or not.
Okay.
So you have to respect that. So, this is something that's real to you, that happened something there?
Yeah.
Yeah. How long time ago did this happen? Like, you felt stress about it?
I met some people today.
Yeah. Did it, was just today or you had some trouble with it earlier?
No, yesterday.
Okay. So, how did it make you feel like feeling wise? You got like afraid, angry, or like how did you feel?
A bit nervous.
Nervous, yeah.
I would say. Nervous.
Yeah. Like very nervous or just a little bit?
A little bit nervous.
Okay. So this was just something that happened once, but. So is this something similar to something happened before? So it's like remind you of other things that happened, like similar things happened to you before?
Oh, yeah, you process this. Yeah, I think it's different things that has happened to me before.
Like similar, like this that happened to
them? Yeah.
Okay. So this thing. That made you a bit nervous. Is it like something that you feel is difficult to handle, or it's something that you think, well, I just have to avoid the situation, or how do you think?
I think you can handle it, deal with it, cope with it. I think it's possible.
Yeah.
So with some practice and with some, yeah.
So like, what kind of situation was it? Like, some unfriendly person, or like what's happened?
No, I think it was kind of a nervous person too, as well.
Yeah.
So I think maybe both were nervous a bit.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Okay. So I ask you, if do you feel that you get nervous many times, or it's just sometimes? Or how is it?
Sometimes, maybe when you meet certain kinds of new people, you get a bit nervous.
Yeah.
I don't know how they will react.
Yeah.
How they will respond.
What do you like? How do you think and so on, like when you meet new people, and this is where you get nervous? How's your thoughts going? Like?
Sometimes you get a bit nervous.
Yeah.
You feel sometimes a bit nervous, I would say.
Would that be something that you feel like it doesn't matter so much, or I would really like to handle this if it was possible?
I think one can practice with it if you really put your mind into it, and we try to make it
okay.
So why does this?
Because that's why I told you to hold it still.
All right.
Because if you touch, move your hands like that, then it will also make a false reaction.
Ah. Yeah. All right.
So that's why you have to keep them still.
All right.
So do you have a solution for this yourself, or is this something you need some?
I think
some help with.
I think the solution is the... I'm with something called the Missionary Church of Kopimism.
Okay.
It's an organization that works with cupping and how our life evolves from cuppings. Cuppings, you put the cells in your body is cupping, you know? And ideas are spread to other people when you talk with them, then they copy your language and your behavior. I think that's a way to deal with that.
So that might be so.
Yeah.
That it copies. I show you one thing.
Yeah.
Thank you for coming in. So now I have a question for you. You ever saw this book before?
Yeah.
You know the
yeah, I know.
Writer?
I know. Yeah, I know the writer.
Yeah. So what do you know about him?
He's from the Scientology Church.
It's true.
Yeah. No, and it's like a science fiction author. Yeah.
Okay. So it's true. He wrote science fiction.
Yeah.
But he also wrote other things in science fiction.
Ah. All right.
So he made money actually by writing science fiction and other things.
Yeah.
To make research into the mind of the how the mind works and like you know like what is causing trouble in. It's life. So this book is about how the mind works, and you can just have a read here. Let's see, that's what's in this one. No, it's back in this one.
Sometimes it's with the right one. When you see more,
so you can read this one. See what's it about?
I'm not going to let him buy it. Yes, but I was looking for the little one. Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Can I ask you something? It says that there is a single source of your problems, stress, unhappiness, and self-doubt. Who came up with this reactive mind thing? Doesn't all minds react?
You know, you have a... the mind, the stimulus response mechanism. You heard about that?
Yes.
So this is done some much more research into what this is, and then found something that he names the reactive mind. And to understand what it is, you should read the book or watch the DVD that also explains it.
Okay.
So it's the way to I mean, I cannot make a lecture here about it. I'm not supposed to do either, because if you want to know about it, you get the book or the DVD, and you find out for yourself how the mind works. So this is...
But why are you here doing this? What is your...
So, I mean, I'm doing it here because I read the book myself, and I used it, and I know it works.
Okay. And you're from Norway, I guess?
No, I'm from Sweden.
Sweden, okay.
Yeah.
I have this Norwegian dialect. But why is this... are you doing this for free, or is it like part of the church, or is it like missionary work, or what is this?
I'm doing this because
okay.
I like to do it. So, but the thing is, I'm wondering why you make an interview instead of me.
No, I'm super interested in religion.
So I just want to continue.
Yes, sure. I was just very sorry.
Yeah. So the thing is that if you want to know what can cause that you get other people's feelings in. And just kind of copy them, like you kind of said, like you had someone else that is feeling it, being afraid that you get the truth. In this book, you will understand how the mind works and how this can happen, that you get situations where you feel uncertain, in a way that you maybe don't think properly. So, by understanding what the reactive mind is, and by using the method here, then you can handle the situation. So you can, by reading the book, you can basically get the data for yourself. So you can, like, this is not something you have to believe in, you just have to read it, understand it, and use the method. That's what you do.
Is this a free book, or...?
No, it's 150 Swedish krona.
Okay. Alright. You want to buy it, Gustav?
I think it's a bit expensive.
You think it's expensive?
Yes.
Okay, do you know what it costs to produce a book of that thickness?
I would guess 40 kroners.
Yeah, 40 kroners.
Yeah, maybe. Yes. But you know, it costs also other things to stand out here and do things and stuff. So
yeah.
All the marketing things around.
Yeah, so I know.
I guess it's not a lot of money to understand how the mind works, if you really want to know. So then you can, but you have to read it yourself.
All right.
You cannot just,
make a circle. Can I make a circle?
Reading circle.
With my friend, somebody.
If you buy the book, what you do with the book is up to you.
All right.
Of course, you can do a reading circle and let other people read it. But you should, of course, get the knowledge if you're interested yourself.
Mm.
If you're not interested, then don't buy it.
All right.
Because then you're not going to read it anyway.
No.
So you buy it if you want to know more about the mind, and that you will know when you have read the book.
All right.
And understood it. Because that's not always the same.
No, bye. Thank you for the test.
Yeah.
And I think I'm.
Yeah. You're welcome.
Bye.
Bye.
Tick.